Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's episode, we will talk about creating a shopping cart in PowerApps. So for this, I have created two lists in SharePoint. So first one is product items, where I am listing out a list of items here. This is the name of the item, it's the price and the image link. And then I have another list called product order, where I am going to place this item as an order. So now I go to Power Apps, and then I create a gallery where I am going to list out all the products. So now I have to connect this to SharePoint. So my connector would be SharePoint. Then I'm going to copy this back here and connect here. And your sites might be already connected here, so you can choose from here as well, but I'll just connect. And I want product items first, so I'm connected to product items. And then so the data over here is now being listed here. And then do some tweaks, like putting a dollar sign here. So I'm putting a dollar sign here. Then I want this image to show my product. This is my list of products. Oops. I want this product to be added to my cart, so I don't need this button. I'll put a button called add to my cart. Just a little bit smaller font. Alright, so now my list of items is done, and now I need another gallery where I am going to show my selected products. So again, I'm going to add it to the collection whenever add to my cart is clicked. So I go to on select and then collect. So let's call it product order. Then I can give an ID of my product. Can give my whole item. And then price. Though everything is there within the item, but since price may change when you are adding to the cart, you might want it to be displayed once it's added to the cart, even though it's changed. So here you go. So this is my cold product order. I'm going to put it here and then I'll add to my cart. So now I come here. I want this to be my item dot title and this to show dollar. Alright, and this to show the image link. I can just copy here, paste here, and put item in the front. Now remove this. I can put a delete. So what this gives you is you can delete this item and you can add it again. Now I want to have a field where I can put the quantities. So insert a text box. On default, it will be 1. Ext quantity. The quantity that we are going to use. And another label that will tell me it's 2. This item dot price. Multiplied by value. So we are multiplying the value of text quantity dot text. And close this. And put a dollar sign. Oops, dollar sign. So now let's try this. Put it 2 here. 60, put it 1, it's 30. All good. Now let's keep adding. All right. So now I might need a button that clear all these things. So put a border. Have a button that clears everything. You just want to clear cart. Clear. And you can add it again. So now we want to buy everything. Maybe let's see what we have. We have order plan. So maybe you can put a small label that says your name. Address. Probably phone number. All right. Good. Text field. Oops. We can move it a little up. Sure. We can put a box to make it fancy. Okay, so this, remove this, and this, you can put a hint text. Number. Now when you put shop, so this is gal cart, so I'm going to take all the items from the gallery cart and I'm going to put for all gal cart dot all items, right? And then I am going to patch the name of my SharePoint list is product order. So, okay. I think product order is not added yet. So I'll add a SharePoint demo site and product order connect. All right, it's here. Product order, and since we are adding the items, so we'll put defaults product order. So we want to add title. The title is this record dot price dot item dot title. Next point is we want to add, what's the next field for item price? For item price is this record dot price, and next point is to add quantity. So quantity is this record dot text quantity dot text since it's a number, I'll put value in the front. Let's close all this, and test how it goes. So let's format it. Click shop and check here. Okay, it's here. So now let's keep on adding. Quantity is there. We need total price. So total price is this price multiplied by this value. And we have ordered by is this field, which is txt ordered by dot text, and shipping address is this address. Dot text, followed by phone number, which is txt phone number dot text. Display this, click here, and everything should be here. So now we need to clear clear this gallery once we submit it. So for that, I am going to copy this and put it at the end. Let's delete all these. Add few more items. Put extra values and shop. Come out here and check here, and it's done. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel to stay updated for more videos like this. Thank you so much.